What's up, nerdlings?
What up, nerdlings?
Do you nerd for?
Pickups!
Do you nerd?
This is Tom and Lacey, collecting all the things, searching from here to there, finding comic book tables, house Legos, and action figs, retro gaming, amiibos, and image prints. Watch as they collect them all. Tom and Lacey collecting right now.
Let's talk pickups. So we've just been grabbing a mishmash items all over wherever we can, mostly online. Found some fun stuff, had some stuff sent to us, and we wanted to share that with you guys. Shall I?
You shall.
All right. Well, of course, we love our video games, and we have been picking up some fun ones.
Booyah, we have.
First of all, anybody get in on that limited run game Streets of Red? Now, they did have a nice collector's edition, but I just wanted to play the game, so I just went the standard route this time.
Here comes a new monster!
Went ahead and picked up Far Cry New Dawn. I think someone was hoping that we would get this sooner rather than later.
Yeah, because we just finished 5, and so, you know, the story's fresh in your head. You want to pop on the next one.
Very true. And already, the little bit of time that we've put into it, just starting it up, man, is it colorful.
It's pretty, yeah. I expected it to be, like, desolate since, you know...
Wasteland?
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to do spoilers or anything if you haven't done 5, but it's like... Yeah, I didn't expect it to look like this.
Listen here, rabbit. If we can't take it, we'll break it.
While we could still go to GameStop, I took advantage of their 4-for-20 deal on games $9.99 and under, and got some things that our collection shouldn't be without, like Dragon Age, Inquisition. I mean, anything to do with dragons, you're on board with.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
And one that I actually did get more for you was The Raven. Remastered. Not because you like birds, it's because of the kind of game that it is.
No, it's not for walking through doors.
They are not for feeling doorways.
I also got Darksiders 3 because I had been looking forward to this game, and for $9.99 or free after buying the other two, I wasn't going to pass that up. And then something cutesy, Penguin Wars. I mean, you like penguins already, so now you get to watch them fight.
Penguins.
Is penguins. Crested penguins. Parent penguin heading home. So why are these woodlands so attractive to penguins?
Well, I got a new video game too. I guess I can share it with you, though. Animal Crossing!
Oh my gosh.
Who is not playing this game
so
right now?
So, how long were you waiting for this one?
Since New Leaf came out.
Well, let's see. I mean, you loved Happy Home Designer, right?
For 5 minutes, and then I got bored because all I could do was design houses.
Well, what about the party game on the Wii U?
I think that was like maybe 5 seconds.
And the mobile game?
Okay, that one I played a little longer. That one was like, okay... For if that's all I could get, but I wasn't going to be satisfied with that. But this, oh my gosh. I feel like they listened to everything we have ever said we wanted in a game in the Animal Crossing world, and they've done it. And I was so glad that they released it a day early. And I actually bought it digitally so that I could play it on my Switch, and then the physical version for you to play on your Switch so that we could actually go to each other's towns. This is the first time we've ever had an Animal Crossing game that way.
Yes. You know, one of my favorite things about this is the fact that you can customize your whole island.
Yes.
It's not just your house, but I mean, you can move buildings, you can terraform, you can move the trees, everything. You can put furniture and stuff and items just out wherever.
I know. Why? I never understood why they would give you outdoor type furniture or yard stuff and you can't put it outside.
That used to drive me nuts.
Yes. And to go along with that, we got a placemat. I mean, it's not really a placemat, but it could be.
Oh, yeah. Laminate that thing up. That'd be a perfect placemat. It was
so much fun. So cute. A little back. Although, I'm having a hard time. I keep still calling it my town instead of a little island.
After our time at BransonCon 2020, spending so much time with our new buddy, Kevin Sorbo. This one was super sweet. And look what she got.
The whole series.
Now, to be fair, the one thing that bums us out about this is it does not include the 5 movies. So we're going to have to track those down on DVD. But yeah. All 6 seasons, and holy moly, that's a lot of stuff to watch. But I'm super ecstatic to get our Hercules on.
Hercules, Hercules, Hercules!
Speaking of conventions, that leads me into some of the mail items we've been getting. Unfortunately, MGC 2020 was canceled. And that sucks because we were going to meet up with so many YouTubers for the first time and we were so looking forward to it.
And it was our first time going to MGC.
It was going to be so exciting. And check this out. Our buddy, 8-Bit Glitch, sent us one of his sleeves. Since he doesn't get the chance to give it to us in person, he sent us one. Video Game Dust Sleeves, putting his awesome work to the test yet again.
Although this makes me sad.
Whatever. This makes it super valuable. This was the convention that never happened. This is a collectible item. So, the only thing is now, 8-Bit Glitch, you're going to have to let us know which game to put in here.
Yep. Everybody else that we've gotten sleeves for has told us what games they want in their sleeve, so you've got to do that now.
All right, so guys, be sure to follow 8-Bit Glitch, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube, and I'm glitching out. The mail from buddies continues because BK hooked us up with some nice cables for our TI-99. If you guys check out BK's channel, he was running you through quite a few TI-99 games, and it's awesome because finally that system's getting some love. I feel like in the last year's time, we've been hearing more about the TI-99 than ever before, with both BK and Retro Mikey. These should make things look a little nicer than having to depend on just that RF outlet through that switch box that I don't even know how that thing's still going. Now, if you know anything about BK, he's quite the giver, and he wasn't just leaving it at cables because he sent a little extra. Bad kids. Who would that be?
Hazer!
Not only did we get a koozie, but he didn't even send it empty. Oh, Almond Biscotti Retribution.
This I like biscotti. Is
a barrel-aged almond and chocolate imperial stout.
Hey, we got something for that to go in, don't we?
We do, actually. Check out the pint glass from Gaming Off the Grid.
Yeah, our buddies at Gaming Off the Grid gave us a really, really cool pint glass so that we can fill it up with our favorite beverages.
All right, so we let it chill for a few days and we've let it breathe now. So this is the Almond Biscotti Retribution, a barrel-aged almond and chocolate imperial stout.
I definitely feel like I can smell the almond and the chocolate.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there is that nuttiness of almond to it.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you open a bag of almonds. Ooh. That chocolate really comes through. as a stout, this is one of those, like the other one that BK sent us, that has a sweetness you're not expecting from a stout.
Yeah. It's almost like a dark bitter chocolate.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
It has a really nice colored head to it as
well.
Yeah,
it does.
Just the whole coloring in general.
Normally, yeah, the heads usually are fairly light. This one is a very, like, a dark tan color to it.
And it's thick. It's got a hardiness to it.
Mm-hmm. It is, it's very good. It kind of makes me think almost like, doesn't have a coffee flavor, but kind of makes me think of cold coffee, like that kind of thickness to it.
Yeah, that consistency. And then like with the, like you said, the dark chocolate flavor to it. Tasting it, I don't get as much almond, but I still get that almond smell
from
it.
Yeah, when you smell it, yeah. The chocolate, I feel like, overwhelms it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like the taste of the bitter chocolate overwhelms the almond, but not the smell.
Well, that is very good. So thank you for sending it to us. And in the koozie, no less, to keep it safe here. And, oh man. You're too nice of a guy to be sharing this with us. We're even squeezing in some toys of sorts with this pickup. Now, ladies first.
I got me a Funko. I got a cute little Funko.
That's a pretty big Funko,
it's
too.
It's a big Funko. I feel like it could almost be like life-size, but I think Gizmo was maybe a little bit bigger than this.
Yeah, he was.
But Gizmo and his little red remote control car. And his little head turns, so if you want him to look this way, or this way.
You just don't start doing that exorcist thing. Oh my god, Gizmo, no!
What'd you get?
I got Mistress of the Dark, Elvira. And look at her lounging there. I could not resist.
I'm not sure which part of her is bigger, her hair or something else.
Good question. Elvira, we know you're watching, so you let us know which you think is bigger. We actually picked these up at Hot Topic because they were having like some super deal Funko.
Yeah.
And they're always having some kind of sale, so anytime you can actually pop into the shop, it's usually worth it just for that quick glimpse to see if there's anything you'd want to get. I think we ended up leaving there with these for, what, $5 each?
I think so.
Goodness dear, I'm so sorry.
No worries. Now I can work at Hot Topic.
And last but not least.
As she said, last but not least, I hit up JP Switchmania.
Come to Switchmania. Come to Switchmania. Tasmanian devil.
And I got from him issue one of Nintendo Power. I had this issue long, long ago. When I first started my subscription, it was a little after the fact, but they used to sell their back issues. And it's funny because they sold them for so, so cheap. Now, unfortunately, I lost a lot of those Nintendo Power that I used to have, but I've got issue one again. And this one is really cool because there's a few variations here, such as the logo itself is a little different sized, and it does say Premier Issue 1988. The biggest, though, is Free Sample Copy. I believe that this would have been the magazine that perhaps you would have gotten if you were a member of the Nintendo Fun Club. So this might have been the mail out to say, hey, if you like the Fun Club, you should subscribe to the Power, Nintendo Power. The edge is a little rough on the cover, but it's a magazine from 1988. So, I mean, it's the fact that it still has the cover is nothing short of impressive. I did flip through this and took a walk down Nostalgia Road. It does have the poster. It does have the contest insert. And it even has the subscription insert, so it is complete on the inside, and that's what matters. And finally, we've got it back. Although, look at that. I love that. That blue Mario hat. Okay.
I just want to squish it because they're clay. I just want to, like, especially his nose, like, just squishes clay nose.
Oh no. Well, there you have it. Nerdlings, pickups all over the place back when we could actually go out into the real world, and some fun online stuff, plus some awesome gifts from our YouTube buddies. Feel free to leave a like if you happen to like the video, and drop some comments down below what you think of any of these toys, games, if you've tried the beer, what you think of 8-Bit Glitch, or even if you love Nintendo Power, or what have you been up to in Animal Crossing.
Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go over to TeePublic because we got merchandise over there. Hit us up on the Retro Refresh. If we like it,
we nerd it for pickups. All the stuff.
All right. I have an island to take care of. This is taking too long.
Yeah, well, this cable's been yelling about going to fight Apocalypse for the last hour or so. Because I'm going to take him out.
Apocalypse!
No! Not Apocalypse!
No, seriously. I have an island to take care of. I'm very busy.
What's up, nerdlings?
What up, nerdlings?
Let's talk about pickups. It's not. We're Do You Nerd. Work the Do You Nerd in there.
Do You Nerd for pickups.
So, shall I?
Shall you? Try that again.
Ready?
Yep. I'm random.
What are you doing?
I feel like they... Ready? I feel like they... Stop sliding! Take
it. Just... Hold it. Just hold it. Stop pressing on it. Come on, red face.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
No, I'm not ready. Okay. Hazer! Put the loading screen above my head.
So we got a...
Where'd that voice come from? Nope. Cut my yawn short. That means I'm gonna have like two now. Fiverr. Yeah. About. Cut that out. That's stupid. Whatever.
You like Knox? Yeah. Yeah.
Open what? Six?
Six?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, six is good.
Okay. Yeah. It's great.
There's a real smile.